With our stopping states added into our system, the only remaining states are the jumping and light landing states. Before we take a look at those states though, we need to add something else first, automatic rotations. If we take a look at Genshin Impact, if we press a movement key like S when looking forward, and then press it right after, the player will still finish rotating itself, even though we are not pressing on the key anymore. Genshin offers this automatic rotation in multiple places, when dashing, when stopping, and when jumping. In the dashing state, if we ever tap a movement key to change its direction in the middle of the dashing or even before dashing, the player will still finish rotating. In the stopping state, the player simply finishes rotating towards the direction that the player was going to move. This means that it actually automatically rotates when stopping and not when moving, which makes sense as we already rotate while moving. In the jumping state, we have two possible outcomes. If by the time that we enter the jumping state, we are pressing on a movement key, then the player will rotate and jump towards the movement direction, even if we were looking somewhere else. This happens either we leave the key pressed or unpress it, as long as it's after we enter the jumping state. If by the time that we enter the jumping state, we are not pressing any movement key, then the player will jump towards its facing or forward direction, which doesn't really need any extra rotation. We'll be adding the first two cases here and then add the jumping case whenever we add jumping into our system, which should be right after this. Thankfully, when we've added movement to our player, we already created reusable methods that allow us to rotate our player, so it will be quite simple to add this feature. We'll start with our stopping states, so open up the player stopping state script in the stopping states folder. What we'll do here is quite simple. In the physics update method, we'll simply make sure our player keeps rotating until it reaches the target rotation. We'll use the physics update method as our reusable methods use the rigid body move rotation method, which involves physics. So in the physics update method, above the rest of the code, call in rotate towards target rotation. We don't need to check if it reached the target rotation already, because we already do that inside of the rotation method. And that's really all we need to do. Whenever we enter a stopping state now, it will finish rotating even though we are not pressing on a movement key. When that's done, open up the player dashing state script. When dashing, we want to keep rotating in two occasions. When we enter the dashing state with a movement key already pressed, and when we press a movement key while already in the dashing state. Now, in the first case, because we'll be calling our move method, we'll already be rotating our player. However, it's possible that we release a key right after, which means that our player will stop rotating. Because of that, we need to make sure we somehow keep rotating. For the second case, let's say we enter the dashing state without any movement key pressed at all, and then pressed and unpressed a movement key mid-dash. For example, we could go from idle to dash and then press and unpress S quite fast. Because we aren't reading for that change in input anywhere, our player won't keep rotating towards where it should when we release the key. With that in mind, let's start by creating a new variable by typing in private bool should keep rotating. Then in our enter method, after we add the force, we'll type in should keep rotating equals to state machine dot reusable data dot movement input different turn vector 2.0. This will become true if we are pressing any movement key, or false if we are pressing none. This is just in case we release the key right after to make sure it keeps rotating regardless. For our second case, we'll need to make this variable true whenever we press a movement key. which we can know through the performed action. So add a new region named Reusable Methods. In here, override the add and remove input actions callbacks methods. Then add a new callback by typing in statemachine.player.input.playerActions.movement.performed plus equals on movement performed. Don't forget to remove it as well. Remember that performed for the value action type will be called right after started and every time a new key is pressed, even if we didn't release the old one, which is what we want. I'll add this method to the input methods region and also rename the parameter to context. Inside, all we need to do is to set the should keep rotating variable to true. When that's done, we need to make our player rotate, so head over to the iState methods region and override the physics update method. In here, first check if not should keep rotating, and if we shouldn't, we can then return. Otherwise, we call in rotate towards target rotation. That's mostly it, but we currently have a problem. Let's say we are facing forwards and tap S. This updates our target rotation to be backwards. In the middle of this rotation, however, we press Shift to enter the dashing state, because by the time we have entered the dashing state, there was no movement key pressed, our player will dash towards its facing direction. However, at the end of our dash, we'll transition to the hard stopping state, simply because we were not pressing any movement key. What happens next is that our stopping state will rotate towards its target rotation, which is still backwards from when we have pressed our S key. This happens because we are only updating our target rotation when we move, and we haven't pressed any movement key since the first S key press. Thankfully, this problem is quite simple to solve. Whenever we dash, we simply need to update our target rotation to be our player forward direction. So in our add force on transition from stationary state method, type in right after we get our character rotation direction, update target rotation. For the direction, pass in character rotation direction. For the second argument, we'll pass in false, as we don't want to consider the camera rotation, but only the player forward direction or our movement input direction. There is one more thing regarding our dash rotation, which is at what speed our player rotates. If we take a look at Genshin, our movement and stopping rotation should be around 0.14 seconds. This is how I obtained the 0.14 from our existing target reach time. However, in both the dashing and jumping rotations, the rotation takes only about 0.02 seconds. Let's update this rotation reach time by opening up our player dash status script. In here, after our speed modifier, add a new field serialized field, public property of type player rotation data named rotation data. I'll give it a private set. When that's done, go back to the player dashing state script. In the enter method, we now simply type in statemachine.reusableData.rotationData equals to dashData.rotationData. Of course, we don't still have this property, so generate it by pressing Alt Enter and choose Generate Property. Then go to that property and make it set public. We of course need to set its default value, so open up the player movement state script, and in the initialize state method, just before setting our reach time, type in state machine dot reusable data dot rotation data equals to movement data dot base rotation data. Then swap the movement data dot base rotation data from our reach timeline with state machine dot reusable data dot rotation data. When that's done, select these two lines and extract them to a new method named set base rotation data. I'll make this method protected and add it to the reusable methods region. The reason why we have made this a new method is because we need to make sure we set our rotation data back when we exit the dashing state, as otherwise our rotation will keep on being 0.02 seconds. To do that, open up the player dashing state script. Then, in the iState methods region, override the exit method. In here, call in set base rotation data. When that's done, save it up and add back to Unity. In the second inspector tab, update the dash data rotation Y value to be 0.02 seconds. If we enter play mode now, our player should rotate correctly even when we unpress our movement keys.